Hi guys, welcome to SA Technical. In this video, I am going to show you how to fix Windows 10 and Windows 11 startup problems. Our computer is not starting up. A Windows-based computer might encounter startup issues for various reasons. When addressing boot problems, begin by identifying the specific phase in which the computer experiencing a halt among the following stages, such as pre-boot, Windows Boot Manager, Windows Operating System Loader, and Windows NTOS kernel. In this stage, the computer firmware triggers a power on self test and loads firmware configurations during pre-boot process. This phase concludes upon detecting a valid system disk. Subsequently, the firmware reads the master boot record, initializing the Windows Boot Manager. Windows Boot Manager. In this stage, the Windows Boot Manager locates and initializes the Windows loader situated on the Windows boot partition. Windows Operating System Loader. In this stage, necessary drivers essential for launching the Windows kernel are loaded, prompting the initiation of the kernel execution. Windows NTOS kernel. In this stage, the kernel loads the system registry hives and other drivers designated as boot start into memory. It then transfer control to session manager process, which initializes the system session. Additionally, it loads and starts devices and drivers not marked as boot start. However, now let's try to understand from which phase the problem is actually coming. And I'm sure this video will definitely help to troubleshoot Windows 10 and Windows 11 startup problems or computer is not starting up problems. So let's get started. First, you will need to ascertain if the system has successfully navigated through the BIOS phase. Disconnect any external peripherals connected to your computer, such as printer, external storage devices, and including an Ethernet cable. Verify the functionality of HDD or SSD light on the physical computer. A non-operational light suggests a potential stall in the startup process at the BIOS phase. Press the number lock key and observe if the indicator lights toggles on or off. Failure to toggle indicates a potential halt in a startup process at the BIOS phase. If the system appears to be stuck at the BIOS phase, it could be signify a hardware related issues. Here's a certain tutorial on how to fix computer stuck on BIOS phase. Boot loader phase. In that case, the system displays only blinking cursor on a black background. Or if you encounter specific error codes, it signals a stuck boot process within boot loader phase. This error code may include issues such as missing or corrupted boot configuration data, corrupted boot files, master boot record, a missing operating system or operating system not found, corrupted boot sector, missing or corrupted boot MGR, or an inability to boot due to missing or corrupted system hive. To troubleshoot this Windows 10 and Windows 11 boot phase problems, you will need a Windows installation media to start your computer. If you don't have a Windows installation media, then here's a certain tutorial for you. Okay, once you have a Windows installation media, insert your Windows installation media to your computer's USB port and restart your computer. During startup process, press the BIOS key repeatedly to enter in your PC's BIOS. Once you are in your PC's BIOS, go to Boot tab and select your Windows installation media as the primary boot priority order to boot from that. Once done, save configuration changes and exit from the BIOS setup utility. Alternatively, you can enable BIOS Boot Manager key from the BIOS. And during startup process, press the BIOS Boot Manager key repeatedly to enter in your PC's BIOS Boot Manager. And then select your Windows installation USB and press enter to boot from that. On the install Windows screen, click Next, then click on Repair Your Computer. Now select Troubleshoot from the Choose an Option screen. Okay, now select Startup Repair. The Startup Repair tool is designed to automatically address numerous common issues and provides a means to swiftly diagnose and resolve more intricate startup problems. Upon detecting a startup problem, the computer initiates the Startup Repair tool, which conducts diagnostic process. This diagnostics involves the analysis of startup logs files to pinpoint the root cause of the problem. Once the Startup Repair tool identifies the cause, it attempts to rectify the problem automatically. After the startup process is completed, click shut down. Now remove the Windows installation media from your computer's USB port and then turn your PC back on. If not solved, the Startup Repair tool generates a log files to help you understand the startup problems and repair that were made. You can find the log file in the following location. If you don't know how to fix this issue, then here's a certain tutorial for you. In order to troubleshoot this problem, insert your Windows installation media to your computer's USB port and boot from that by following previous method. On the Windows installation screen, press Shift plus F10 key combination for command prompt. Note, this method is only for legacy BIOS-based computer. If your computer is UEFI-based, then here's a certain tutorial for you. To repair the boot code, type bootrec space forward slash fixmbr and press Enter. Next, to repair the boot sector, type bootrec space forward slash fixboot and press Enter. If you got accesses denied, then type bootsect forward slash nt60soes. Note, executing bootrec alongside fixmbr specifically replaces the master boot record. If the corruption in the mbr affects the partition table, running fixmbr may not fix the problem. If it's not working in your case, then here's a separate tutorial on this issue. If the stop error indicates system file corruption, run the system file checker in offline mode. In order to troubleshoot this problem, first insert your Windows installation USB to your computer's USB port and boot from that. Now click on Next, then click on Repair your computer. Select Troubleshoot from the Choose an Option screen. Now click on Command Prompt. And now you will need to identify the system drive letter. Type bcdedit and press Enter. Then you will see your system drive letter. Now type your system drive letter and give a colon and press Enter. Next type dir and hit Enter to confirm. Okay, as you can see, this is my system drive. Okay, once you confirm, type sfc space forward slash scan now space forward slash off wood dir equals to your system drive letter colon backward slash space forward slash off win dir equals to your system drive letter colon backward slash windows and press Enter. Okay, now keep patience until the process is completed. Okay, as you can see the message, Windows Resource Protection did not find any integrity violations. Or if you see the message, Windows Resource Protection found corrupt files and successfully recovered them, then no problem. Now reboot once, after that hopefully Windows startup problems will be solved. If it does not work, then try to recreate Windows BCD. Here's a certain tutorial on repair Windows boot partition, and I'm sure it will definitely help to fix the problem. And please don't forget to let me know in the comment section. So I hope this guide was helpful for you. If you have any question or any advice guide, then please let us know. Please like, comment and share. We need your support. And guys, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.